Hello, and welcome to my vlog. In this vlog, I'll talk about mise-en-scene in the film Black Panther. What actually is a mise-en-scene? Mise-en-scene is what makes up a film, like the setting and props that the film used to give location to the audience, costume, hair and makeup to show what type of people they are and what they are wearing. Facial expression and body language is used to show how a character is feeling or how a character is feeling to another character in that certain scene. Lighting and colour to show what kind of day it is and to create an atmosphere for the audience, whether that be a happy emotion or sad emotion through light and dark lighting. The position of character is used to show what a character is feeling about a different character in that film and just where they're positioned in the frame. So now I will add in a clip from the movie Black Panther and we will analyse it together.
I now offer a path to the throne.
The merchant's tribe will not challenge today.
The border tribe will not challenge today.
The river tribe will not challenge today.
The mining tribe will not challenge today.
Is there any member of a royal blood who wishes to challenge for the throne?
This corset is really uncomfortable. So could we all just wrap it up and go home?
After watching that scene, what did you think of Black Panther? Did you see any of the props used, or the costumes, or any of the body language from one character to another? But first, I'm going to talk about the setting of a film. In this film, it's set in Wakanda, which is a fictional village, hidden away from the rest of the world in Africa. The whole lot of Wakanda is run by a substance called vibranium. The setting for this particular scene is on a cliff edge / waterfall, which for the scene it creates a tense atmosphere for the audience as they fight on the cliff edge. For a scene, the setting is a key factor which shows the audience where the film is taking place and the surroundings that the character is in. In the scene, they are fighting on the edge of a cliff because the main character is about to become king and has to fight someone of the real tribe to show he's worthy of becoming king. Next, I'm going to talk about the costumes used in this scene. They use colourful tribal outfits to show that it's set in Africa. There's many people watching on the cliff wearing all types of outfits like headscarves and fine fabrics, and some are even wearing masks and a turban type headwear and headdresses. Some of the women actors in this scene are wearing some tribal dresses of many different vibrant colours, and the majority are wearing sandal-type footwear. Also, most of the characters have a lot of jewellery, like bracelets, big necklaces, and huge earrings on. They also have very big hairstyles, and some even have dreadlocks. Also, the makeup is used to create tribal patterns and designs on the faces of the actors. The lighting in the scene is high-key lighting to create the illusion of a bright day. The lighting complements the costumes of the actors very well, as the bright, vibrant clothes and the lighting go well together. Lighting is more important than you'd first think. It's also more than just brightness and darkness. Lighting can be used to highlight any important characters or a certain object in that scene. Bright light is normally used to create a happy atmosphere for the audience, whereas a dark light would be used for sadness or a disturbed scene. There is high-key lighting and low-key lighting. Low-key lighting is used to create a sharp contrast of light in darker areas or shadows or even silhouettes, normally in a lot of drama films or spy films, in my opinion. High-key lighting is used to create a natural, realistic light which is more pleasing to our eyes as the audience. It's normally used in rom-coms The facial expressions in any scene shows the character's emotions to the audience to let them know how they're feeling and what type of mood they are in. If someone has a wide smile on their face, we assume they are happy. Also, body language is a giveaway sign of what mood the character's in, or how they feel towards another character. If they're crossing their arms or facing away from another character, as the audience, we would see that as someone who's annoyed at another person. Lastly, positioning of the character within the frame can make our attention be drawn to something important in that frame, e.g. a character or an object, and can also be used to show the relationship between people. For example, if it was a group of people standing close together in a circle smiling, we'd assume that these people are friends, whereas if we saw a group of people standing apart from one another, not really saying much and then looking really unhappy, we as the audience would see this and feel as if those people aren't really friends. So I hope you enjoyed this vlog about Mise en scène in Black Panther. See ya!